The first thing we're going to make is tartar sauce. This sauce is perfect for any kinds of seafood, including crab, fish, or fried oyster. In News Day, I've seen Jung Yumi made this sauce by herself. In that program, she added pickled garlic stem, but I chose to put a pickled cucumber instead, because I was not able to get a pickled garlic stem for this sauce. You can just buy tartar sauce if you want, but it tastes much better when you make it by yourself. I think it is because I squeeze ample amount of fresh lemon juice inside. It is very refreshing and flavorful. The oyster is considered to be a food for high-end restaurants in Western countries. And that's why a lot of people taking oyster as a raw food. However, oyster is very common in Korea. It only costs $3 for 200 grams. And that's why we put them in a soup or sometimes fry them in a large quantities. However, there's something that you have to know before you cook an oyster. When you buy an oyster in a market, there's a lot of impurities sticking on their surface, such as shells, sand, or sometimes a little dirt. And that's why it's always important to wash it thoroughly. When you use a grind radish, it'll be much easier for you to wash an oyster. Put a grind white radish on an oyster and toss them using a hand. The oyster is very fragile, so always do this gently. When you do this for several minutes, you'll find out that the white radish will turn to gray. It is because radish absorbs the dirt on an oyster. Then take them out one by one and pour a fresh water on it. See how shiny it is, very clean. Then you're ready to put them on a batter. I'll use a frying powder at this time, but you can use any kinds of flour if you want. The frying powder is just a mixture of flour, salt, and garlic powder. Pour a fresh oyster on a frying powder and coat it with a light layer. Then crush 3 eggs and remove chalasa from it. Whisk them all together. Plunge coated oyster into a beaten egg. Actually, this is my favorite part of making a fried oyster. I like to see oyster floating on the beaten egg. Flip them to the other side so that oyster will be covered with an egg. Lastly, roll them down on a bread crumble. Then you're ready to fry an oyster. Put 2 cups of oil in a pan and preheat them in a medium heat. Before you fry an oyster, make sure that they are in your right temperature. Put a wooden chopstick inside and check the bubble coming up on the surface. When you fry an oyster, you don't need that much amount of oil, because oyster is small enough to fry in little amount of oil. Plunge battered oyster in an oil and fry them for 4 minutes in a medium heat. Fry them until they become a golden brown. Then I'm gonna take them out from the oil. When you finish frying oyster, shift the particle inside an oil. Then you can fry dozens of oysters again. Leave fried oyster on a paper towel and cool them down for several minutes. Let's dip the fried oyster in a tartar sauce. The sour taste of tartar sauce goes well with a fried oyster. If you are to try my recipe, please tag my ID in your Instagram and subscribe my channel for more interesting recipe ideas. See you in the next video!